What's up, Jeff?
What's up, guys?
Yeah, look at these roots right here. Look at the block wall right here. Looks like it's cracking.
What about this huge crack right here?
We haven't seen cracks in a while.
Huh. That's not a good start. The outside looks good, the roof looks good, the driveway looks bad.
It's a cute neighborhood, definitely like nice starter homes.
So it's a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom, it's about 1750 square feet, and the guy's asking 450. Well, it looks like someone lives here.
Someone lives here?
Hey, I talked to the guy, he said no one lives here. Why don't you come in? Look, I feel like we're walking into someone's house.
It does look like someone lives here.
Hello?
There's even like a dinner tray set up.
That's a weird floor plan.
So you can tell.
You can tell they've done additions.
And they like did a semi-remodel in here.
Oh, yeah. Keep that lighting for sure.
This is the worst lighting I've ever seen.
Let me see what you look like. Oh, wow, it is bad lighting.
I wouldn't be talking to him.
I always look good. I don't need any light.
Tarek has a mirror that lies to him.
Okay, we got a laundry room sitting right off the kitchen.
The laundry room is so big. Don't you feel like we need to open up the kitchen on one side? It's like this weird tiny little box in the middle of nowhere.
So I feel like we're gonna have to open it up. My question is that wall load bearing? Is this wall load bearing? And is that wall load bearing?
You know, in all reality, I don't know either, unless I come and start opening up walls. You don't own it yet, right?
No.
I'm not cutting holes in somebody else's house.
Okay, so, let's just say we didn't remove the wall, we just remodeled the kitchen. What do you think it would run?
The way it is, you're looking right around 12 grand.
All right, like, this is a nice room back here. It has a fireplace.
So dark.
This is a good sized room though. Look at the size of this patio. Whoa. It's a huge yard.
Oh my gosh, what's under there?
He said he's gonna be leaving trash with the house.
I should probably. Is this considered trash?
I don't know, I didn't ask that, so I have to call him.
Because leaving some trash or leaving the entire dump?
Or what do you think it's gonna cost to clear it out?
Just in the backyard, maybe 12 to 1500.
This has to come down.
This has to come down.
So this thing, you want to take that down, maybe another 400 bucks.
What's the word?
The bearer of bad news.
There is going to be some bad news on this place. As of right now, what I'm looking at is 116.
116?
116.
Oh my God.
That does not include if any of those walls are load bearing that we want to take out. You've got a lot of work to do in here.
We thought we were going into like a simple house like back in the day, and now it's costing a fortune. Does that price include all the trash?
No. If we have to take out all of the trash, front yard, backyard, in the house, everything, you're looking probably another 3,500 bucks.
So you're telling me this is $120,000 without any structural?
Right.
All right, I guess I'll just let you know.
Cool, let me know. See you guys.
So, bye.
See ya. Let's just say we paid 450, put 120 into it. We all know it's gonna be higher than that, but that puts us at 570,000. We're gonna have $30,000 in closing costs, commission, and staging puts us at 600,000. Comps are 650.
Not much wiggle room.
If we can get this house for 420, do you think we should buy it?
At 420, I feel like that's safer. 450 is pretty risky.
Well, at 450, the deal just doesn't work. This is the same house? Oh my gosh, it looks different.
Well, this wall's all gonna come out. So imagine how much different it's gonna look once all this comes out.
I have a question. Where do we put the cabinets? This wall is not here. That wall is gone. We only have one wall.
And also, now I sort of feel like, look how small this room is. I feel like this room's gonna look tiny. It's almost like everything needs to be flipped over there.
Oh, you're talking about moving a kitchen. Oh my gosh, it would probably work, huh? We could probably do an L shape right here, right? So we have this wall, and then we could run this wall. We can end it somewhere in this area.
Do a big island right here.
You know what we could probably do? Build the island into the post so it doesn't stand out as much.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, it's gonna cost at least, I don't know, I think $3,000 to $5,000 to do it.
I think we kind of have to, or it's gonna look really weird. The layout of this house is so much better with open walls. And moving the kitchen from the center of the house to the side wall will create a flow that will definitely impress buyers. And I think since it's all opened up, what if we do more of like a modern industrial style, something different, like white flat panel cabinets?
All right, let's do it. All right, so we're doing the kitchen today, right?
Right, so I brought some flooring samples. I brought a white flat panel cabinet. I know we talked about industrial modern.
Well, let's start with countertop.
Let's pull some concrete looking ones.
Yeah, these are cool right here, actually. These are really, really neat.
So, backsplash.
Oh, that one's nice.
Right.
Let me see that one. Ooh, look at these two together. That's really pretty.
That's pretty.
All right, we're done. Let's get out of here.
No, no, no.
Those bricks?
Brick actually could be We actually could look really nice.
I mean, that is really, really buyer specific. I'm just saying.
Just pulling it. So I feel like this is a pretty safe move. It has the industrial vibe. Everyone likes a hex.
Well, this one's definitely my favorite. I mean, the brick, it's different, it's unique, but I'm just a little bit worried about putting that brick in Norwalk. Not really a hipster neighborhood.
It is a little risky. How about we save this look for a different house, and for this house, we go with that. It's still industrial modern, but it definitely is more contemporary, and I feel like everyone's gonna get it.
All right.
Are we sold?
Sold. This looks good.
Yeah, it does. It's a big shower. Both bathrooms were tiny and cramped, so we borrowed space from the huge primary bedroom in the hallway and changed the layout so the bathrooms were side by side, which makes them both more usable.
So let's start with the materials.
So I think we do white flat panel. This is like sneaky, right? Gray or white? I think we go white. It's tiny in here. So white flat panel cabinets. And then this is an option shower walls.
Okay, what's this one for?
This shower pan, or shower pan and all the shower walls, like a party.
Oh, the dark?
Yeah, everywhere.
In the whole shower, I think that would look really, really nice with a white grout.
All right, cool.
Does it look good?
Perfect.
I mean, I think the house looks cute. The paint colors look nice.
The paint does look really nice, actually. Looks good.
Wow, look at that entry.
Looks like an entirely different house.
Looks like you're walking into like a high-end home in LA. You can see from the front door all the way to the back of the house. You know, I was pretty hesitant to spend the money on this one, I'm not gonna lie. But now that it's done, it honestly looks awesome.
Like all the light flooring and the white cabinets really just makes the black pop.
And I like the accent color we did here and then we did back here.
Yeah, it looks really cool.
And look at that fireplace.
Yeah, it's definitely a statement.
It just looks so much better.
I love the hex on hex. We have kind of a hex theme here, which looks wonderful.
Uh-huh.
There's definitely a lot of sitting areas. So you have like the formal kind of living room when you walk in. Then you have the more functional family room. We have a huge dining room. We have an island. Like this house has everything.
It's a great house. All right, look at that backyard.
The good thing about this is we did not spend a lot of money. Just like the front yard, all we really did was some paint, sod, got rid of a shed, and it looks like an entirely different space.
Looks really, really good.
All right, let's go see the bedrooms.
So this was bedroom one.
It's small, but it has a nice view. It works. So basically we reconfigured the two bathrooms and I think this is still a really nice sized bathroom. The design's clean, light and bright.
Looking good, it's looking fancy. It's modern.
Bedroom two, this one's really cute. Has like a little bohemian vibe.
Yeah, this is cute. Right now we have the long hallway to the primary. Tell you what, this is a huge bedroom. It really, really is.
Yeah, it is.
And then this. I feel like we almost doubled the size of this bathroom.
I'm glad you made an executive decision to not do the entire thing, the black tile, because I think it would have felt a little too dark.
This came out red. I like this. I like this whole look in here.
Looks good.
Well, what are we gonna list this thing for? That's the big question. With the construction and all the work we did, we spent $157,000.
That's a lot.
It's gonna cost us $30,000 in closing costs and commission, which gives us a break even right above $617,000.
Okay.
Maybe $699,000.
$699,000 and hope for multiple offers, hopefully drives it up to the, you know, mid sevens.
I mean, some of our listings, we've been getting $20,000, $30,000, $50,000 over asking.
Yeah. I think the $699,000 makes more sense.
All right, $699,000.